The skill that we have chosen to teach our cognitive learner is known as the volleyball pass.
Let's first see how the autonomous learner performs a volleyball pass with precision and consistency. This is the same skill performed at a slower pace.
Now that we have seen an autonomous learner, let's break down the volleyball pass into its separate regulatory cues. Regulatory cue number one. Step out with dominant foot.
Regulatory cue number two. Begin to fold hands together. Regulatory cue number three. Bend both knees parallel to the ground. Regulatory cue number four. Hit volleyball on forearms. Regulatory cue number five. Slightly straighten both knees. Now let's take a look at the cognitive learner on our first few attempts. I say hello, my friends in LA, they don't know where I've been for the past few years or so. Paris to China to Colorado, sometimes as airplanes I can't jump out. Let's take a look at her common errors in all three attempts.
In this attempt, she missed the ball due to improper form, which slowed down her reaction time. In this attempt, she mistakenly swings her dominant foot and proceeds to hit the ball with her hands, which causes the ball to ricochet forward. In this attempt, her form is very stiff from not bending her knees, and she seems to be focused on the area around her rather than the volleyball.
After some practice and guidance from the autonomous learner, the cognitive learner has showed signs of significant improvement. Here are some improvements since her first few attempts. In attempt number one, she correctly stepped forward with her dominant foot and bent her knees.
In this final attempt, she correctly performs each regulatory cue, which are stepping with the dominant foot, beginning to fold the hands, bending the knees, hitting on the forearms, and straightening out the knees.
Let's take a final look at the cognitive learner with and without practice. Just for kicks, let's look at the differences between the cognitive and autonomous learner.